Good morning to all. Thank you for the invitation. I'm going to present a tricky clinical pilot study about the alcohol and the HS. I have no conflict of interest. And the free learning objective will be the alcohol role in developing and maintaining HS lesion, and if there's a phenotype of patients that can benefit more to discouraging this kind of behavior. And third, but last but not least, in what way we can assist that alcohol use. So in Italy, the ISTAT is an organization and a health organization that each year promotes surveillance about the aspect of life in all Italy. In 2015, it promotes a surveillance titled Aspetti della vita quotidiana, that means daily aspect of life. They assist like 45 million people, such as 19 million families, and we found that 9.5 million people are formerly alcohol abusers. So the trends are also changing from the avarias, and the alcohol use became earlier and earlier. There's a daily consumption increased, and also the phenomenon of binge drinkers. That means people that drink more than 6 glasses with impairment of a daily function. But come back for my topic. What the alcohol really, in what way it the axis monocyte and macrophages? Friends are hepatologists. Found that there's a direct and linear proportional correlation between alcohol use and serum macrophagic markers, especially CD163 and CD14. But going in depth, in the thymus, the alcohol use is demonstrated this year by Bizyaku, that the alcohol increase the clearance of apoptotic thymocytes. In that way, decrease the possibility of self-antigen to be presented, and so decrease the possibility to develop an autoimmunitary disease, an autoimmune disease. But on the tissue, on the resident macrophages, the alcohol increases the activation specifically increase the polarization M1 via NOTCH1. That is the same pathway that is involved in for example, presenilin and other mutation that we found in familiar HS. But and the other way, that hyperactivate also the inflammasome that is present in the early lesions, both in neutrophils and in macrophages. But going to the literature, we shuffle the literature, I found only two studies, two case control. One that have 87 patients, and the other one that use and compare ECD code. And in both of them, we found no link with alcohol abuse, interestingly. But as we know, there's a difference between alcohol use and alcohol abuse. And in this background, we assist the macrophages in HS. And in literature, the early lesions are infiltrated by the neutrophils and macrophages, as the team of Van der Zee described a few years ago. But at the same time, macrophages, especially the papillary infiltrate, are the main sources of interleukin 12 and 23. That have a key role in the polarization of T17 lymphocytes that represent a bridge, an immunitary bridge between innate and adaptive immunity. But going to the characteristic of macrophage, they have an hyperexpression of TLR2, and that is of comfort for the theory or microbiological trigger. There's an hypersecretion of metalloprotease 2 and 9, saying that these lesions are going to evolve and change the tissue architecture, and there's an hyperactivation of inflammasome. This inflammasome is present inside macrophages and neutrophiles, giving the reason also to the autoinflammatory origin of HS. Our study is to detect the role of alcohol in HS patients' life. Our study design have a multi-center prospective observational studies with two moments of investigation, T0 and T1, after 3 months. So that the inclusion-exclusion criteria, shuffling rapidly the inclusion criteria, they are people that have more than 18 years old, no pregnancy, no transplantation, no concurrent autoimmunitary diseases, and a senior consent form, of course. So at T0, we assist the anamnesis, the patient history, and we visit our patient, and we do the static score, the ARLEY and the ADDI, that was recently proposed as a new tool to assess the overall of autoinflammation impact in all tissues. It was originally developed from the monogenic autoinflammatory diseases and experimentally adapted to HS only recently. And we use also the dynamic score because we want to see the evolution. We use the modified Sartorius and the new international HS4. But from the part of a patient, we are interested also to have a patient referral score. So we insert the DLQI and the audit. That is a tool approved by WHO in order to assist the alcohol role in the life of a patient. And we encouraged all the patients to have a patient's diary alcohol consumption, because of if you write, you are more responsible, and we can increase the confidence with the doctor. Okay, in that situation, we think to add something. We are currently collaborating with the engineering of Milan, and we put all the data of T0 into a big machine that uses artificial neural network. Artificial neural network are a computerized system that have no a priorism, that inspire to the human mind, and analyze all data, and allowed us to find the so-called hidden correlation. Why hidden? Because if I don't think to correlate one item to the other one, I can't find the correlation. In contrast with artificial neural network, I put all my archives, all my items that were simultaneously correlate each other. And give the that map. So all the items of the autoinflammatory disease damage index were put here in order to find clinical phenotypes, because I can direct better my intervention if I focus on the group of patients that can benefit more. And here, we found 4 phenotypes. Briefly, the first phenotype are characterized by a low impairment of whole body by autoinflammation with low DLQI and low sartorius and have less than 25 years old. The second group is characteristically gender divided because from one side we found male that have fertility problem and have an early free and are ranged between 36 to 45. And from the other side, we found women that have musculoskeletal problem, that have 26 to 35 years old, and an early two, and the LQI very large. On the third phenotype is split in two, one that have renal problem, and the other one that have puberty problem, but interestingly, both are from patients that have more than 46 years old. The fourth phenotype that have the higher level of autoinflammation in all the body have, interestingly, early one. So that means that if we see early as a systemic disease, we have to start to see behind the skin. Ultrasonography could be one solution, but we need to have a multi-system approach, a multi-specialist approach. Because that patients that have very high level of autoinflammation need, for example, here ocular involvement and ophthalmologist, hear loss and otorhinolaryngoiatric. So with that stratification, we are able to see that is the score. All the dead patients to the first visit was requested to decrease alcohol consumption. And in order to give the rationale, we administered a video of 10 minutes about the negative effects of alcohol. That's the audit in depth. So if for patients that have more than 7 points, we need an intervention. Our patients drink more than 5 times a week alcohol. There's 2 binge drinkers in 127 patients, so it's not a so problematic issue. But the clinical profile 1 and 2, so lower autoinflammatory level, have the higher audit, so use more alcohol than the others. And by using that situation, we analyzed that phenotypes, and we found that there's an increase of high international HS4, so the dynamic score, only in that patient. That means that the alcohol have a higher impact in patients that have a mild disease. In patients that have a high contribution of autoinflammation, the external factor may be less, like alcohol, may be less important. We have to concentrate our educational efforts in that patient, at least in relation of that pilot study. So the takeaway message is, despite alcohol abuse is not prevalent, alcohol have to be discouraged because it's frequent. And patient with mild to moderate disease can benefit more. And the daily alcohol needs to be discouraged in all patients with HS, also for cardiovascular comorbidities or metabolic ones at least. Thank you for the attention.